Today we are going to study about shear force and bending moment diagram. This video clearly made for those students who have never studied shear force and bending moment diagrams. So going to the first part, it is shear force. Shear force is at a point in a beam is the force which will try to shear off, that means cut off the beam. So it is the force which try to cut off the beam, that force we call it as shear force. So in order to find the shear force at a point, we need to sum of all the forces to the left of the point or the right of the point should be considered. That is summation of forces either to the left side or to the right side of the point we should consider. And when we consider that, we need to follow some sign conventions that is written here. Sign convention for shear force, and this is the point where we need to calculate the shear force. So if you calculate shear force towards left hand side, left side upward force should be taken as positive and left side downward force should be taken as negative. Similarly, if we calculate shear force towards right hand side, right side downward is taken as positive, right side upward is taken as negative. Next we have bending moment diagram. So before going to the bending moment diagram, we need know what is bending moment. Bending moment at a point in a beam is the moment which will try to bend the beam. So it is nothing but the moment which will bend the beam, that moment we call it as bending moment. So if we want to calculate bending moment at any point, we need to do sum of moments of all the forces and moments to the left side or right side of the point we should consider. That is bending moment at any point is equal to summation of moments either to the left side or to the right side. Okay. And we need to follow some sign convention for that. Okay. You can see the bending moment sign convention. If we have pure moments, okay, for that we have one sign convention, and if we have the forces, then we have the second sign convention. You can derive the same sign convention based on this particular force sign convention. So for bending moment, actual sign convention is, this is the point where we are calculating bending moment. Okay, if we calculate bending moment towards left hand side, left side clockwise is positive, left side anti-clockwise is negative. Right side clockwise is negative, right side anti-clockwise is positive. This is the sign convention we should follow. Okay. Similarly, if we have forces in the beams because of which bending moment develops, then this is the point where we are calculating bending moment. And if we calculate bending moment towards left hand side, downward force is taken as negative, upward force is taken as positive. Similarly, on the right hand side, downward force is taken as negative, upward side taken as positive. This is easy to remember. You can remember like this, both side downward is negative, both side upward is positive. So if you remember this, automatically you can remember this by doing the moments. For example, this is the point, with respect to this point, this force is making anti-clockwise direction. So left side anti-clockwise direction is negative, that is what we have written here. Similarly, left side, this force makes a clockwise moment with respect to this point. So left side clockwise is positive, that is this positive. Similarly, with respect to this point, this force is making clockwise moment, so right side clockwise is negative. Similarly, with respect to this point, this is making anti-clockwise, so right side anti-clockwise is positive. So this is easy to remember. Only thing we have to do is both side downward is taken as negative and both side upward will be automatically positive. Next we'll go with the next part. Going with the next part, it is variation of shear force and bending moment diagram. So you can see a tabular column here. It is written type of loading, how the shear force varies, how the bending moment varies. So if there is no load, shear force will be horizontal line, whereas the bending moment will be linear bar inclined line, a straight bar inclined line. And if the loading is point load, that is a single force, then shear force will be a vertical line and bending moment, there will not be any change. Similarly, if the loading is UDL, your shear force will be linear bar inclined, whereas bending moment is parabola. And if the loading is UVL, your shear force will be parabola, the variation of shear force will be parabola, and bending moment will be cubic parabola. And for the moment, there will not be any change in shear force, whereas in bending moment you can see a vertical line. So same thing I have written here. This is only to understand. Okay, you can see this is the shear force diagram and this is the bending moment diagram. So in all the points you can see there is a upward force of 74 kilonewton, 74.28 kilonewton, and there is a downward force of 80 kilonewton. Wherever you have forces, the shear force lines are vertical. From you can see here, this is a vertical line, this is a vertical line. So wherever you have a force or a point load, the shear force line will be vertical. Similarly, you can see there is a UDL acting from C to D. So wherever you have UDL, the shear force diagram will be an inclined line. Similarly, if there is a UVL, that is uniformly bearing load, the shear force diagram will be a parabola. Okay, and whenever you have a moment, shear force is not affected by moment, since it is a moment and this is shear force diagram. This is particularly force diagram, variation of force diagram. Similarly, you can see the downside, you have BMD. For BMD, wherever you have a point load, no change is there, you have only points here. And whenever there comes UDL, you have a parabola in the bending moment diagram. And whenever there is no load, between, for example, you have from B to C, there is no load, you can see there is a inclined bar straight line. Okay, linear bar straight line. And wherever you have a uniformly varying load, your shear force, bending moment diagram will be a cubic parabola. That means it will contain terms x raised to power 3. Here it's the parabola, x squared terms will be there. And you can see here there is a moment in the point E. The same point in the bending moment diagram, there will be a vertical line. So this figure, you can clearly understand how the variation is there. Next we go with a simple problem where you can understand clearly how to draw the shear force and bending moment diagram. So we have a problem here. We have a beam A to B for which we need to draw the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. Okay, so we have UDL acting from A to C, we have a point load of 5 kN, we have a point load of 3 kN, and the spans are given. Whenever it is asked to draw the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram, the first thing we need to do is calculate the reactions. You can see here, this is a hinged support. So wherever there comes the hinged support, actually there develops two reaction. One is vertical reaction VA, second one is horizontal reaction HA. Here also it's a roller support, hence develops only one reaction, that is VB. So we need to calculate what is VA, what is VB. So we go with the equilibrium conditions. First, for this particular case, I will apply summation of vertical forces is equal to zero. So if I apply summation of vertical forces is equal to zero, it implies how many vertical forces are acting here. One is VA is a vertical force which is acting upward. VB is a vertical force which is also acting upward, and 5 kN is a vertical force acting downside, 3 kN is a vertical force acting downside, and also we have a uniformly distributed load, that is A to C, acting downside. So here we will adopt one sign convention, that is upward arrow is positive and downward arrow is negative. So upward forces are taken as positive, downward forces are taken as negative. So VA is a upward force, so I will take it as positive plus VA, and VB is a upward force, so I'll adopt VB as positive, and we have 5 kN acting downside, so minus 5 kN, and 3 kN also acting downside, minus 3 kN, and this UDL is acting downside. So whenever you have a UDL, first you need to convert this UDL into an equivalent point load. That you can do by multiplying the UDL with its span. The span of the UDL is 2 meter and the intensity is 2 kN meter. So 2 kN meter is multiplied with the span. Okay, this should be equal to 0. That is what we are meaning with summation of vertical forces should be equal to 0. So now we are equated. So we will get a one equation, VA plus VB is equal to 12 kN. This is what our first equation, that you can take as equation 1. Next, we will go with the summation of horizontal force should be equal to 0. This is our second equilibrium condition. Here in this problem, you can see you have only one horizontal force, that is HA. So this HA, no other force is acting, so HA should be equal to 0. So the value of HA is 0. We will go with the third equilibrium condition, that is summation of moment at any point is equal to 0. So if you can calculate summation of moment at any point, for example, it can be calculated at A, C, D, E and B, anywhere you can calculate, provided it is better to calculate at point A so that VA and HA will be eliminated automatically. So I will calculate summation of moment at A and it should be equal to 0. So here we will adopt one sign convention, that is clockwise moment we will take it as positive and anti-clockwise moment is taken as negative. And this sign convention is nothing to do with the bending moment sign convention, that you have to remember. Here and clockwise is positive, anti-clockwise is negative, that's all. Now we are calculating bending moment, summation of moment at point A. So all the moments are calculated with respect to point A. So you can see here, there are many forces acting. First I will go with the UDL. With respect to this point, this UDL is acting clockwise. This UDL is acting clockwise. Hence, first you need to convert this UDL into a point load. So conversion is nothing but 2 into 2 is the conversion. When we convert it, the UDL will be, the equivalent UDL will be acting in the center. This value is 2 into 2. Now, in order to get the moment, moment is nothing but force into perpendicular distance. So with respect to A, the perpendicular distance is this one, and this value is nothing but 1. So with respect to A, it is plus 2 into 2 into this becomes force multiplied by perpendicular distance is 1. Similarly, we have with respect to A, this 5 kilonewton is acting clockwise. So plus 5 kilonewton into perpendicular distance from A is 4 meter. Again, we have 3 kilonewton with respect to A. This is also acting clockwise. So plus 3 kilonewton into perpendicular distance from A is from this point up to this point. It is 4 plus 4. It is 8. Again, with respect to A, this vertical force is acting anti-clockwise. So minus VB into perpendicular distance is 10. This should be equal to 0, from which you will get the answer for VB as 4.8 kilonewton. You can substitute this in equation 2 so that you will get the answer for VA as 7.2 kilonewton. So this is how we calculate reactions. So VA is 7.2 kilonewton and VB is 4.8 kilonewton. You can see here the same problem I have written here. Now we are going to draw shear force diagram. Shear force diagram, it is nothing but force diagram. In order to draw the shear force diagram, you should follow the force direction. That is very easy. So we will start from left hand side. This is our point A. This is our point B. We have point C, D, E. Always we will start drawing the shear force diagram from left hand side. Here we need to follow the force directions. If the force is moving upward, the shear force diagram will move upward. If the force is acting downside, your shear force diagram will act or go downside. Okay. For example, you can see there is an upward force of 7.2 kilonewton. So we will start from 0. At A, there is an upward force of 7.2 kilonewton. So your shear force has to go up by 7.2 kilonewton. So I will go up. From this point, the shear force has to go up by 7.2 kilonewton. From A up to C, there is a UDL acting downside. So your shear force has to go downside, because from this point it has to go downside because the UDL is acting downward. It is also a force which is acting downside. So you need to go from this point, you need to go down. So 7.2 minus the UDL will give you shear force at this particular point. So 7.2 minus 2 into 2, it is 4. You will get the value as 7.2 minus 4, it is 3.2. From C up to D, there is no force. Whenever there is no force, the shear force will not change. So shear force will be always a horizontal line. And this point is nothing but 3.2. Okay. Exactly at point D, there is a downward force of 5 kilonewton. So this point has to go down by 5 kilonewton. So 3.2 minus 5, you will get it as 1.8. So I will go down by 5 kilonewton. So I'll get the answer as 1.8. This is minus 1.8. So minus, we already write it downside, so it indicates minus. Again, from D up to E, there is no force. So your shear force will not change from D to E. So shear force will remain constant, or you can say it is horizontal. Exactly at point E, there is a downward force of 3 kN. Hence, this point has to go down by 3 kN. This point is -1.8. If you deduct again with 3, the value comes to be -4.8. So -1.8, -3, it is -4.8. So this value is -4.8. From E up to B, there is no force. So shear force will not change. So it will be a horizontal line. And this value is 4.8, -4.8. Exactly at B, there is a upward force of 4.8 kN. So this has to go up by +4.8. So you will get the answer as 0. So this is your shear force diagram. So shear force at A is 0 and 7.2. Shear force at C is 3.2. Shear force at D, you have two values. One is 3.2, the other one is -1.8. Shear force at E, you have two values. One is -1.8, second one is -4.8. And shear force at B is -4.8 and 0. Next, we will go with the bending moment diagram. For that, first thing we have to do is calculate bending moment at each and every point. So to calculate bending moment at any point, it is nothing but summation of moments either to the left side of the point or to the right side of the point. Now, bending moment at any point is nothing but summation of moments either to the left side or right side. So now first we are going with point A. We'll go with point A. You can see here at point A, if you want to calculate bending moment, either you need to calculate summation of moments either to the left side or to the right side. Okay, if you go left side, there is no force acting, so directly you can write bending moment is nothing but summation of moments, which is nothing but zero. Since there is no forces acting, no moments are acting, hence you can take it as zero. So bending moment at A, we'll write in a format like this. So bending moment at A towards left side is equal to zero, because there is no forces or moments are acting towards left side of point A. Now we will go with point C. Bending moment at C, we'll go with left hand side. At point C towards left hand side, there are two forces are acting. One is 7.2 kN and UDL from A to C with intensity 2 kN per meter. These two are the forces because of which bending moment develops. So bending moment is nothing but force into distance. Okay. So first, with respect to C, this force is left side upward. Left side upward for bending moment sign convention. You can see here, we are calculating bending moment towards left hand side. Left side upward arrow is positive, left side downward arrow is negative. By using this sign convention, okay, we will calculate bending moment at point C. So this is equal to left side upward is 7.2 kN, it is plus 7.2. This is a force, you need to calculate moment. So 7.2 into distance. With respect to C, the distance from A is 2 meters, so 7.2 into 2. And this is a UDL acting downside, so left side downward is negative, so minus 2, okay, into 2. When we do this, the UDL is converted into equivalent point load, which will be acting in the center. Now with respect to C, the distance from C to the equivalent point load is half of the span of the UDL, that is 1 meter. So 2 into 2 will convert the UDL into point load. If you multiply this with the perpendicular distance, it will be converted into moment. So this force is multiplied with the perpendicular distance. Now we have added two moments. One is 7.2 into 2, it is a moment, and 2 into 2 into 1 is also a moment. So this we call it as summation of moments to the left side. And the answer comes to be 7.2 into 2 minus it is 4. So the bending moment at C comes to be 10.4 kilonewton meter. Now we will go with point D. Bending moment at point D towards, either you can calculate towards left hand side or you can calculate towards right hand side. If you calculate towards left hand side, you will be encountered with two forces, 7.2 kilonewton and the force due to this UDL. If you go towards right hand side, you will be encountered with two forces. One is 3 kilonewton and 4.8 kilonewton. So any side you can calculate, you will get the same answer. So first I will go with the left hand side. If I go with left hand side, you have two forces. One is 7.2. So left side upward is positive. So plus 7.2 into perpendicular distance from D is 2 plus 2. It is 4. Now the second force is the UDL. So first convert the UDL into point load. It is minus 2 into 2 is the conversion, that is UDL will be converted into point load. Now this equivalent point load from distance D, so from point D, the perpendicular distance is 1 plus 2, it is 3. So the bending moment at D comes to be minus 16.8 kilonewton. If you calculate the same thing on the right hand side, you will get the same thing, that is right side upward arrow is positive. So 4.8 into 6 minus 3 into 4, the answer will be 16.8. Now we will calculate bending moment at point E, that will do it towards right hand side. Okay. So bending moment at point E towards right side. Okay. Towards right side of this point, there is only one force acting because of which bending moment is going to develop. So that force into perpendicular distance will give you the bending moment. So right side upward arrow is positive. So plus 4.8 into perpendicular distance is 2 meter, so it is 2, so the answer comes to be 9.6 kilonewton meter. Similarly, at point B, bending moment at point B towards right side, there is no force, hence bending moment can be taken as 0. Once you get all these values, you need to mark all these values. So bending moment at B is 0, bending moment at A is 0, bending moment at C is 10.4, so I'll mark it somewhere here. This value is 10.4, bending moment at D is 16.8. So you can mark somewhere here, this is 16.8. Bending moment at E is 9.6, this is 10, so 9.6 will be somewhere here. This is 9.6, and bending moment at B is 0, all this we have marked. Now we need to join all these points. You can join, you can see here, you have a UDL acting from A to C. So whenever there is a UDL, the bending moment will be a parabola. So you need to join these two points using a clockwise parabola, that is like this. Okay, always you should join using a clockwise parabola. Okay, now from this point, that is from C up to D, there is no load. Whenever there is no load, you just join these two lines using a straight line. Okay, so you will get a inclined line, something like this. Inclined bar, straight line. Again from D to E, there is no load. Whenever there is no load, you can directly join without any curve. So this can be joined with this using a straight line, straight bar, inclined line. Again from E to B, there is no force, so you can join these two using a straight line, so it can be like this. So this is your bending moment diagram, and all the values are positive. In the shear force diagram, this is negative and this is positive. So here you can, here we have solved one full question. Okay. If you like the video, please like and share, subscribe. Thank you. We'll go with the next problem in next video. Thank you.